Realtors abide by a code of ethics. This is Article 9 in action. Beth, a first-time homebuyer, knew nothing about the home buying process, except that she wanted to buy a home. But her realtor had the expertise to make sure Beth understood every document, even giving her copies to review with her lawyer so Beth could close on her first home with confidence. Complicated things explained in simple terms. The difference between an agent and a realtor is real. Realtors are members of the National Association of Realtors. That's who we are.
This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. As we continue to listen, learn, and grow, we are amplifying Black voices and perspectives in an effort to start a new COVID-19 vaccine conversation. We're sharing stories intended to help us navigate this unprecedented time together and to co-create solutions in support of the Black community. Hear these stories at WeConsiderWA.org.
What's up? It's your boy, The Ben Smith. Thanks for listening to the Men's Room Daily Podcast. Want more? Check out the greatest podcast in all the land, The Podcast. Be sure to subscribe and listen to a brand new episode every Tuesday night.
The debauchery rolls on. You're listening to The Men's Room with Miles and Thrill. 99.9 KISW.
Coming up, your guests are as good as mine in categories include obese states and the top 10 best holidays. First time for a few emails to the men's room at KISW.com.
You've got mail.
See what we got here. Jumping to the birthdays, guys. I want to wish a happy 39th birthday to my husband, Matt. He is the best guy and mean the world for a shout out on your show. How about your penis is too small and a big old bong rip? Oh, thanks, guys. That from Kaylee. Cholas and the Dirty Germans. I'm turning 39 today. For my birthday, I would like Steve Shotgun Getz with a Bruce Willis roof that don't leak in the middle. Maybe the captain talking about what to drink for your birthday. Thanks, guys. That from Dan in Renton, who says, P.S. Ted, congrats on your winning record this year for Ted versus the FCC.
Oh, hey, thanks, Dan.
Get.
She got a roof that don't leak.
Ahoy! You ought to know what to drink on your birthday. You drink any of the perspiration of the belly of the woman you're spending time with. Or the man. Or animal, I don't judge. Four legs or less, it's all good for the captain. Crunch bears.
Gentlemen, I want to wish my son-in-law, Luke, a very happy 42nd birthday. Amazing guy and really helped us this weekend with his time and patience, helping us move our new fifth wheel, since neither my husband nor I have a clue as how to do it. So I'd like Coach Ted to tell Luke that helping out old people is a great thing to do. Thanks, guys. That's from Tanya, who always carries a knife.
Tanya. A weird thing to throw that in there, but hey, got to keep a blade on you. I get it. It's Luke, right? First of all, Luke, helping anybody out is great for other people. But these are old people, and they're struggling. They don't know what they're doing with that fifth wheel. You come through, you help them out. Now also, this ass ain't free. Better make sure you can take that fifth wheel on a trip if you want it.
Okay. All right, Coach, let's see here.
Guys, I texted in asking you to give my coworker Aaron a little turtle sex and Black Hulk explaining how this holiday work party is going to be the greatest he can remember, because we're going to get him wasted at that position by to celebrate him turning 21 today. We did have a good prank already to kick off the week for him. Oh, thanks, guys. That from Josiah. Hola, guys. My name is Steve. And I know that my family won't email me, but for my birthday, I would like a Kevin Hart dam, a happy Chinooka, and Miles giving me some words of inspiration. Thank you, guys. That's from Steve in Kansas City, who says, go Chiefs.
Damn! Happy Chinooka.
Okay, let's see. All right, Steve. Steve, in life, never be afraid to just talk to strangers. I struck up a conversation with a spider today. He seemed nice enough. And like most of the people who live in my neighborhood, he too is a web designer.
Oh.
Gentlemen, I have a birthday request for my first and longest time friend, Kevin. Actually a pretty decent human being. Today he turns 42. I bet he'd like to know what the Dirty German's plan to do with him when he inevitably passes out this evening. Cheers, guys. That from CF.
Yeah, when you pass out, I hope you do it with your mouth open. We play a little game called the Gherkin Drop.
Yeah, I like to call it fishing. It's a private pond.
Yeah, it's kind of like ice fishing. One teeny tiny hole and we drop our bait.
Yeah, maybe you've had a long night and you have one of those sleeps where your mouth is wide open. And your voice dry. Well, help make it damp.
Yeah, you'll wonder what your morning breath is. You'll be like, did I eat Fritos last night?
Gentlemen, today is my colleague Dan's birthday. As long as I've known him, he's excellent to work with, and I quite enjoy his chill personality and positive attitude. He's been down in Arizona doing great work for the Army Corps Phoenix District. I'm sure I do miss his presence here in Seattle. Can the Dirty German suggest what fun could be had with bagels and cream cheese for our next trip to our favorite bagel shop? Thanks, guys. That from Alex.
Yeah, bagels and cream cheese, that's quite obvious. You put your penis in the hole of the bagel, and then you say, this isn't everything.
Yeah, so see, that's the funny part here. So if you let the two Germans come by, we provide the cream cheese.
Yeah, self-spreading.
Yeah, it's also with that bagel.
Guys, want to do a birthday shout out to my loving husband, Steve. A very happy 62 rounds of the sun. Can I get the Dirty Germans talking about the big 62? And maybe some turtle wax, whether your penis is too small. In his case, too big. Thanks from your loving wife of 35 years, Sherry. P.S. We're the ones that send BJ and Migs the special painted Kraken bottle of rum. Thanks, guys. We love the show. Well, thanks for sending that to us. We'd sure love to have a bottle of rum.
Yeah. Great.
Yeah, nice.
Great. She wants a D, and she's going to get one.
Yeah, you tell the big 62 today. Try, you should try the 62 position. One of you sits and puts your legs behind your heads. The other one simply kneels down with their legs behind them and stares.
Yes, this email caught me off guard. It was so weird. Say, ah, sure. Do us a favor. We sent your other friends the rum. Say, it's just an American thing. Because in Germany, we would never do this.
I hooked up everyone you know, except for you.
Yeah, it's like, honey, I love you, but just so you know, I slept with your buddy.
All right, guys, here you go.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you.
BJ. Yaws of Dirty Germans brought to you by Men's Room Original Sausage. Available through Uli's World Famous Sausage, mensroomlive.com, and other fine retailers. Schweineflash.
Thank you, Alvin. We appreciate it. Let's get a contestant online. For your guess is as good as mine now at 206-421-ROCK. I'm not sure that Robin knows. We're going to try to get her on the Appy Hour before
that is
the end of the, before the end of the week here. Speaking of the Appy Hour, hold up, Cholos. I was just wondering when the Appy Hour is going to be available to hear other than 6 o'clock, 9 o'clock my time, since I live in North Carolina. I work nights, try really hard to catch you all on the app at 9, but I'm a warehouse manager for a huge furniture company in the East Coast and can't always be in my office at 9. I've been listening to you guys for a few years. Love the Appy Hour. Love to hear how you guys really talk and feel about us. Anyway, I love y'all. Keep on rocking, bitches. That's from Carlos in North Carolina. Carlos, we don't have any news on that yet. We're
trying to make it happen.
Yeah, we're one of just a handful of shows within the company that's actually doing a special little thing like that. So it's not that we're the test run of it all, but they're just going to try to figure out how this thing works. And all the shows do it differently.
Right.
I think we're one of the few that do it live every day.
I think we're the only one that actually does it live.
So I'm not sure. But we're trying to make some stuff happen. So probably next year we'll have at least an answer for you.
If that
makes any sense. Pub Mac and Cheese. Ted, if you want to try some amazing pub mac and cheese, head on over to the Church Key Pub in Edmonds for some Beecher's Bacon Mac and Cheese. Also wash it down with an Ain't No Sunshine whiskey cocktail. This flavor combo will blow your taste buds' minds. That's from an avid listener. We're talking about...
Yeah.
I mean, no. It's got bacon in it. It's macaroni and cheese.
I've had it before. It is solid.
And Beecher's, I mean...
Come on.
Their mac and cheese is arguably the best I ever had.
Mm-hmm.
Subject is work hours. You guys were talking about the fixation with having people glued to their desks 9 to 5. Studies have shown that people are actually more productive as well as happier with their job if they're allowed more flexibility in their hours. For anything that isn't time sensitive, I've always preferred to both be paid and paid others at a flat rate. As a worker, you can choose whether to bust your ass and finish the task fast or take your time without getting in trouble for either. And as an employer, you know exactly what something will cost in advance. It's not feasible for everything, but I think it should become more common in situations where it's possible, especially for independent contractors like me who have a good idea of how long things take them. It is a win-win. Cheers, guys. That is from the Crazy Goat Lady.
Crazy Goat Lady?
Crazy Goat Lady.
I think they're all a little crazy.
Yeah, if you're a goat person, you can just throw crazy in front. People go, yeah.
And sure. I mean, I know multiple people that have them. I've told to their face.
How many goat friends do you have?
Goat friends.
Well, Taryn has goats.
Okay.
She's going crazy.
Yeah, she's crazy.
Yeah.
I go crazy. I go nuts.
My buddy Sal, him and his wife have goats.
He has goats. How many goats does he have?
He has two. But he's got, like, smaller ones without horns.
Okay.
Do you have teeny tiny ones, or?
They're smaller. They're kind of funny. But I hated Terrence's first goat.
Do any of these goats...
Does one headbutted you or something?
Yes. Constantly.
Do these goats have any of them have a friendship with you?
Like you're a dog whisperer. Yeah, are you a goat whisperer?
I do not have... I don't know.
Like, I can't wait to see this goat kind of thing?
No, I'm good. I'm good with the goats. I mean, like, don't get me wrong. Like, I'll walk them with Sal and his wife. I just...
You'll walk the goats? They need to be walked like a dog?
They do. They walk them.
You gotta pick up after your goat. I guess you gotta pick up after your goat, but is a goat poop similar at all to a dog's?
Like, oh, no. It looks like cocoa pebbles. It's just really? Tiny little pebbles.
Huh. I didn't know
and
that.
Sometimes they poop while they're walking.
That's living wild. Life.
Yeah, well, hey.
I don't care about nothing.
Multitask. Time for a little your guess. It's as good as mine. It's an easy game to play. You pick from one of two categories. Try to get as many right in each said category before three strikes and you're out, Steve. Who's going to play our last Your Guess Is As Good As Mine for the year 2021?
Oh, his name is Wes Miles. Hello, Wes. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola.
Hola.
Wes, this is huge. You're the last contestant on Your Guess Is As Good As Mine for the year. Wes, do you want to go with the 10 best holidays or the 10 most obese and overweight states in the United States of America?
Let's go obese, because my dad lives in Arkansas.
Let's go obese.
Oh, wow. All right.
I'm going to guess that's on the list.
Wes, last month was National Diabetes Awareness Month, and obesity is costing the healthcare system only about $147 billion each and every year. So the personal finance website Wallet Hub, what they did was they released its report on the most overweight and obese states in the United States. They compared the 50 states and the District of Columbia across 31 key metrics. They range from share of overweight and obese population to sugary beverage consumption among adolescents to obesity-related health care costs. To give you an idea, Colorado and Massachusetts, they have the lowest percentage of obese adults at 24%. Which is a lot lower than Mississippi, the state where 40% of the population is obese.
Apparently, they're the only ones you ever see.
Utah has the lowest percentage of physically inactive adults.
Okay.
16%. Colorado has the lowest percentage of diabetic adults at 7.5%. And Colorado also has the lowest percentage of adults with high blood pressure at 24%. So basically, those states, not in your wheelhouse, on the 10 most overweight weight and obese states. So, Wes, the way we play the game is you got to get as many right in said category before three strikes and you're out. What is your first guess? Will it be Arkansas?
Yeah, let's try that. I've been to visit them a few times, and it's pretty impressive.
Number three. Arkansas is, in fact, the... So you can definitely tell the difference in the size of people when you get to Arkansas?
Oh, for sure. Well, yeah, and then just... the attitude about, like, having to do anything physical.
Okay. All right, fair enough.
Yeah. I mean, you got to put Mississippi on there.
All right. So is that going to be your next guess, Mississippi?
Let's do it.
Number two. So you've got number two and number three. Mississippi and Arkansas. As we said, the one thing that all these states have in common, biscuits.
Yeah.
That's all you need to think about. You've been to a place and people love biscuits. I mean, more so than pancakes, French toast, a lot of other fattening foods out there for breakfast. Specifically, these are some biscuit-loving states.
I would guess that we're going to just kind of hang around the southern area.
That's what I would do.
Yeah, biscuits. All right, Wes, what are you thinking now?
Let's go Alabama.
Alabama, number five.
Yeah. Roll Tide.
So far, you're correct with Mississippi, Arkansas, and Alabama. Yeah. And Wes, no strikes against you. Three for three.
Right. Is it easy to just say the Southeastern Conference in college?
The SEC.
There's one that sneaks in here. There's two states that aren't in this area. Other than that, they're all pretty well in the same general area.
Mm-hmm.
Right. What are your thoughts on Louisiana Tech?
Louisiana, yeah, but I feel like that doesn't show up as much as, like...
Maybe even Texas.
Texas should be on there just because of barbecue.
Georgia, you think? I'm trying to think of...
There's always, like, Kentucky, West Virginia as well.
Right, right, right.
Well, yeah, yeah. Let's do West Virginia.
West Virginia, is that what you said, Wes?
Yeah, yes.
Shocking. West Virginia, number one.
Oh,
West Virginia.
And obese state of the United States of America. Shocking news. When you fly into the airport, Wes, there's only one major airport in West Virginia. It is located in the state capital. Now, there's a couple other smaller ones, but as far as commercial airline flying into some place, mm-hmm. there's one in Clarksburg, but the big one is in Charleston, West Virginia. They have one restaurant. It's called Tudor's Biscuit World. I am not kidding you.
Nice.
Tudor's Biscuit World.
You can get biscuits for dinner, you can get biscuits for lunch, or they're breakfast biscuits.
And nobody in your family's really... Well, you're not.
Oh, I love biscuits.
I think I'm gonna try Florida just because it's messed up in every way.
It is out of the top 20.
Florida's got too much beach.
You got to remember Miami. Right. There's a lot of outdoor activities that go
People
on.
People like to be outside and show skin.
It is hot as hell there, so even if you tried to gain weight, you're going to sweat it out as soon as you eat it.
Well, my dad lived in Florida before he moved to Arkansas, so that's why I was kind of guessing.
Boy, he picks them.
All right, so far you're correct on West Virginia, Mississippi, Arkansas, and Alabama. You've gotten 4 out of the 10 with 2 strikes remaining. What's your next guess on the most overweight and obese states in the United States?
I dated a girl from Tennessee. Let's go, Tennessee.
Number 6. You are absolutely correct. I don't know what you're in.
Did you just call her fat?
No, her family was.
All okay, right. Her family was fat. Did you ever eat any of her, Wes, did you ever eat any of her home cooking?
Her mom's was really good, yes.
Okay, I believe
it. I bet it was.
Hey, look, there's one thing that's one thing universally common in all these states, the food is going to be outstanding.
Oh, yeah.
For sure. I mean, it might not be the best in the world for you. There's a lot of butter involved, but it's going to be tasty.
Let's go with neighbors of Tennessee. Let's say Kentucky.
Number 4. You've got the top 6 states in the United States as far as obesity and overweight people. West Virginia, number 1. Mississippi, Arkansas, Kentucky, Alabama, and Tennessee. There are 2 more southern states on this list. The other 2 kind of crapshoots spread out in other areas.
Right.
What about a place like one of the Carolinas?
That list.
That's not bad.
Because of all the cheese.
You say Wisconsin?
Let's do it.
Wisconsin not in the top 20, believe it or not.
Mm-hmm. Anywhere like Iowa or something, you know what I mean? Just...
Let's pick one more southern state.
A listener in Kansas, they suggest Kansas.
It's not just Arkansas.
He says there are some F's here in Wichita, Kansas.
I did spend some time in Missouri. Let's go Missouri.
Missouri's number 14, Russ. Hey, you got the top 6. Yeah, you too.
Right on, man.
Not bad. You guys got any guesses on the final 4 here?
Texas.
Texas is number 11.
Oh, so close.
Give me Ohio.
Ohio, number 12.
Damn.
Yeah, you guys are right around the edges here.
North Carolina.
North Carolina, number 17.
Damn.
But you're close. You guys are in the
South. Did we say Kentucky?
South Carolina, number 9. Yes, we did. Kentucky was number 4 on the list.
What about Georgia?
Georgia, not on the list.
Really?
There is another southern state left. You've lived there.
I've lived there.
Oh, Louisiana.
Louisiana.
It is Louisiana.
Oh, I thought he did guess that. All right.
Where's that at, Miles?
Number 10, believe it or not, is Oklahoma.
I can believe
on the
that.
List. Yes. And number 7, Delaware.
Really?
Which was kind of shocking to me, knowing I've spent a lot of time in Delaware, but like anything else, it didn't seem too much different, but I guess it is.
You know what? I've been to the beach, Delaware, a couple of years consecutively, and... Yeah, it's a fat place.
Your 10 most overweight and obese states in the United States.
Sorry, man, that beach is not
a fat place.
It is not a good-looking beach. It looks like a great whale die-off. No, it's the people.
Number 10, Oklahoma, followed by South Carolina at 9, Louisiana at 8, 7 is Delaware, 6 is Tennessee, Alabama at 5, Kentucky 4, 3 is Arkansas, Mississippi 2, and your number 1 most obese state, my home state of West Virginia. There you go, and your guess is as good as mine. You are listening to The Men's Room.
Realtors abide by a code of ethics. This is Article 9 in action. Beth, a first-time homebuyer, knew nothing about the home buying process, except that she wanted to buy a home. But her realtor had the expertise to make sure Beth understood every document, even giving her copies to review with her lawyer so Beth could close on her first home with confidence. Complicated things explained in simple terms. The difference between an agent and a realtor is real. Realtors are members of the National Association of Realtors. That's who we are.
This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. As we continue to listen, learn, and grow, we are amplifying Black voices and perspectives in an effort to start a new COVID-19 vaccine conversation. We're sharing stories intended to help us navigate this unprecedented time together and to co-create solutions in support of the Black community. Hear these stories at WeConsiderWA.org.
$20 million, $19 million, $6 million. These are all awards recovered for clients of Phillips Law Firm. To win big, you have to fight big. And Phillips Law has been fighting the too-big-to-fail insurance industry for decades. Not every case will have a multi-million dollar outcome, but Phillips Law will fight just as hard to recover the outcome you deserve. If you or a loved one has been injured in a car accident or on the job, call or click today at 1-800-JUSTICE or visit justiceforyou.com.
Visit Lowe's and take on the Pro Brand Challenge with the new Flex Stacked Lithium Battery. More power, longer battery life, and faster charging. Plus, it's compatible with all Flex 24-volt power tools. Right now, the more Flex 24-volt tools you buy, the more you'll save. Get up to $150 off today. Stop by or visit us online and see Flex. Exclusively at Lowe's. Dial 519-276. Savings vary based on purchase amount. Exclusive versus National Home Centers for Flex 24-volt. U.S. only.
99.9 KISW. The men's room is in progress.
Coming up in just minutes, we'll drink, we'll toast with a shot of the day. And we do have your headlines on the way 1 hour from now. First quick check-in with Mike Hawk and some of the stories and headlines he is not working on.
All right, asked for by nobody. Jet Puffed is selling peppermint marshmallows at Walmart.
Peppermint marshmallows.
Okay. Well, that kind of makes sense for Christmas.
It does. I mean, I get that this is the peppermint season.
Well, if you're going to put in your hot chocolate, it can't be bad.
Do you, Mike? Because your voice says you don't give it.
Yes.
Yeah, I don't give a crap about peppermint. I hate peppermint.
Okay.
I shouldn't say I hate it. I don't mind mints. I really don't. I just don't like it when I'm supposed to be eating it. I don't like it flavoring my food. I like it as a breath mint. I like it as a gum.
Okay.
Leave it out of my ice cream. Leave it out of my marshmallows.
All right.
I'm good to pop a mint. I like peppermints. I like candy canes. But that's one of those foods, to me, that if you're going to have mint, you're just having mint.
I'm generally not a huge like, I like candy canes. I'm not the biggest peppermint person, but I'm like, I don't know. It might be subtle enough in a marshmallow that it sounds good.
I'll give it a try.
Yeah.
Only because Miles brought up the hot chocolate. Like, that actually sounds
good. I mean, you think about, like, the like cream de mint that you might put in coffee
or any
of that stuff. It, typically, mint goes well with chocolate, and it also goes well with cream.
Right.
So if you're going to do the dessert aspect of it.
They're at least more complimentary flavors.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're right. There's a 74-year-old man that's been sentenced to 5 years prison time after receiving his 18th DUI conviction.
Jeez. Wow. That's a lot.
At 74, at this point, is this man even going to learn his lesson?
No.
That's the whole point of prison, right, is rehabilitation. You're going to, you know, pay for your mistakes there and hopefully never do them again. Not this guy.
No. There's no chance.
A man in Arizona was fired from his job as a cop after two simultaneous scandals. This is nuts. He had a sexual relationship with a married coworker, and he let his dog come in and have sex with one of the canine units.
Oh, sweet. Come on. Are you serious?
I am serious.
That's an actual story.
Run that by me again. He did what with the dog?
He had a sexual relationship with a married coworker, which was the first scandal. The second one, he let his personal home dog come in and have sex with one of the canine units.
All right.
Little. Yeah.
Come on, man.
Mm-hmm. Right. They're on the job, man. I mean, we'd all love a little relief on the job, but it's still, we got to be professional in here.
I mean, it's just weird to me that I could look at my dog and be like, I know the dog for you.
Right.
And then it happens.
Man, I know a cute little German Shepherd with your name on it.
I know a cute little bitch that you love.
Should a dog put on the uniform?
Use the handcuffs. Oh, damn. Economists say the market prices of retired Lego sets have grown by 11% annually, making them a lucrative investment. I feel like we just mentioned that.
Okay.
Heads up to folks looking to propose. A majority of women want private and unique marriage proposals. So the days of the big, spontaneous, in the middle of a crowd ones, now, obviously, this doesn't span everybody, but this is more of a majority, but that the days of those have kind of well sailed.
Well, it's not about her.
That's right. Also, I would recommend this. If you're going to do a big grandstanding presentation, know the answer. Maybe go to them and ask first and then make the big proposal just so you don't go through all this song and dance.
No, and go through the song and dance and fail.
Yeah, that's fair.
That's my, look.
Those make videos on TikTok, man. That's how it's done.
And those are the ones worth watching. I don't care if you asked her to marry you and she says yes and she cries and all that. You go like, well, that's kind of how it goes.
Sure.
But like, no, this video, he asks her, she says no.
Right.
Like, ooh, give me the awkward.
I don't watch YouTube videos to smile with glee. I watch them to laugh.
I like America's Funniest Home Videos because something went wrong.
Right.
I don't need videos of things going right.
The new question burdening the internet. How long could you go without power in your home?
You mean without losing your mind kind of thing, you mean?
Pretty much. How long before you hit the button like, all right, I need power back?
Well, the problem is it gets so dark here so early. So when you get home. Yeah,
it does. Right.
It's like, look, I've got a gas stove. I just couldn't see what I was cooking.
Right.
The problem is that my refrigerator's run by electricity, so I wouldn't have any food after a couple days anyway, I guess.
Right. That's kind of the give and take. I can last a while without power. I got no problem with that. But like Miles said, I got a refrigerator with an icebox on top of it with everything melting inside of it. So now I got a major mess I got to clean up. My food's going away. I'm pretty sure my stove is electric, so that sucks.
Everything in my house is electric. I mean, but if you took that out of the scenario, look, dude, I've been homeless, so I can go without power.
Sure.
You know what I mean? Like, if I got a roof, I'm cool.
Right, I'm just at the same boat. Everything's electric.
Right.
And my oven and everything, my stovetop.
And that is likely why the most popular answer was about 5 hours.
We did about 3.5-4 hours. We had a windstorm, I don't know, earlier this year, not the recent ones.
Yep.
But the power went out, man. The kids were about to lose their freaking minds. Because you realize, you know, everything in their world is about electronics.
Sure.
Right? So they didn't care that the lights wouldn't come on. It wasn't that. Like, homeboy wanted to play Xbox, and this was becoming a problem. But we ended up inventing a game and having a good time.
Right. I do like that about power outages, just because of where we're at in our society, especially here in Seattle. We're very, very developed out here. So if there is a power outage, it's never really going to be more than a week maximum.
Oh, God, not that long.
Right.
Yeah, I mean, depending on the damage. Even if a storm, West Seattle had, like, sporadic power outages all of last week in different areas, but there was no real rhyme or reason behind it. Maybe, I mean, obviously there's a reason behind
it.
But it wasn't like this huge storm blew, you know.
Right, but unless a forest falls on all those power lines, it's generally going to be a day, maybe two. So in those times, I like to just honestly grab a few logs for the fire. We light it up that way, light a few candles.
We did all that, man.
Play some board games, man. It's a good time.
It was.
Like going back in time there for a second. Time spent in traffic is up from last year, but still nowhere near before. Drivers lost about 36 hours in traffic this year. 26 hours last year, so we lost about 10 more hours this year. Compared to 2019, any guess on the hours of hours lost in traffic in 2019?
80.
80, not a bad guess. Ted, any guess?
95.
Miles Montgomery.
120.
99 hours in 2019. Mm.
Mm. A lot of people want to work from home. You get stuck in traffic. Most of the time you're stuck in traffic, you're going to or from work.
Exactly.
Most of the time. Obviously, if you're going to a sporting event or something. And then you got to pay to park. Right?
Yeah.
I mean, it's why people want to work from home. They're saving money, saving time. Come on, man.
Exactly. So we're currently at a third of what we used to be. So
damn.
I'll still take that. Rover.com just released the results of its data on the most popular dog and cat names of 2021. Oh, are you ready for this? I do have the top five.
Is it based on, like, movies and stuff?
These ones are no. These ones are the more traditional names. It does say that some people did get creative. They looked to the pandemic for inspiration. It says dogs named Dr. Fauci were up 270%.
Come on.
Gee, I wonder why. The name COVID was up 35%.
You're gonna name your pet COVID.
Right? Jesus. And then people are also naming their pets Pfizer and Zoom.
Really?
Which aren't terrible pet names.
But as a pet name, no, but just because we have an immediate association with something else, like, I don't name my dog
and
Pfizer.
Just with the weird pet names that I've heard in these offices with Dr. Gomez, there's Damn It Carl, there's Franken Accounting?
Rainbow Janet.
Janet.
I like...
So Dr. Fauci isn't all that bad.
I like human names on animals.
Yeah.
Early days when my cat was Larry.
Right.
You know,
he was Senor Larry.
Yeah, well, he was, but I mean, it's just like, say, if you're a doctor, I don't call you Dr. Hawk.
Right.
Mike. I mean, so, but I don't know.
Yours always had a moniker as the thing, and it was great.
Like, if you had, what's your dog's name? Doug.
Right.
I like it with dogs. I find it weirder with cats. I mean, it's still funny.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So any guesses here? So we got female dogs, male dogs, female cats, and male cats. We got the top five of each. Let's start with the female dogs. Any guesses for the most popular female dog names?
Like Belle or Bella, one of those.
Daisy.
Not a bad. Ted?
Little bitch.
Little bitch.
Fuzzy bitch.
Little pump.
So you got it with number five is Lola.
All right.
Number four is Daisy. Always a good dog name there. Lucy comes in at number three. I've known a handful of Lucys.
Mm-hmm. I know a Daisy.
Right next to it is Luna at number two.
All right.
And number one, the top female dog name, I feel like it's each and every year is the same one. It is Bella.
Bella.
Always.
Bella's on that list a ton.
I know it a is. Lucy. I know a Luna. And another Lucy. Lucy, Luna, and there's another name that you said on there, but all, Lola.
Lola?
Yeah. All three of them are people. They are classmates of my kids.
Let me ask
they
you
are
a
not
question.
Dogs.
I had a relative, so to speak, name their child Bailey.
Okay.
When I first heard that name, I thought, that's a dog's name. Am I alone on that?
No. I mean, I know people name their kid Bailey, but it is definitely, in my mind, it's dog first.
Yeah.
Yeah, me too.
I think of a human woman.
Okay.
A human woman.
And I have known a couple
from a different planet.
Me.
I think of a human woman.
I have known a couple Baileys, and it didn't strike me as weird, but if you were to mention the name Bailey, I would think of an animal.
Yeah, sure. Me too.
So,
all right.
The top five male dog names. Male dogs. Any guesses as far as the top five male dog names?
Nacho.
Max.
Nacho. Max.
Max, that's strong.
Ted.
Freddy.
Here are the top five. Number five being Rocky.
Rocky's always a good one.
It's a good dog name.
Is there Dozer on there?
Dozer's not bad. Okay. I've always liked a Dozer. Number four would be Buddy.
Okay.
Another fairly traditional name.
That's just weird as I feel like you call dog Buddy anyhow.
That's why he's named Buddy. Well, it's like people named their kid Guy.
Yeah.
Hey, Guy.
Hey, Guy.
Number three, Milo.
Milo?
Milo.
Oh, yeah. Like the movie.
I have friends call me Milo to this day.
What movie?
Milo and Otis.
Milo was the
actually
cat.
In the title. Okay.
Milo was the cat.
Oh.
Yeah. Whatever.
Number two, Charlie. I've known a couple Charlie dogs.
I know Charlie.
And the number one male dog name, yet again, it is a name that has been there forever. Miles, you nailed it.
Is it Max?
It is Max.
Okay.
All right.
It's a good dog name right there. That's Goofy's son's name, actually. So that's how
it fits.
It is.
Well, gosh.
Yeah, that's right. Female cats. Any guesses on female cat names? Again, this is Rover.com's most popular dog and cat names of 2021.
Is it close to dogs as far as...
I might put Bella back in there.
Okay.
Not a bad
What's the main character? Elsa.
Elsa.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Top five female cat names. Number five being Nala, which was the female lion in The Lion King.
Really? Come on.
Yeah. Number four, Lucy. That's my cat's name. Love her.
As I say, wait a minute. We know a Lucy.
Yeah, we know a Lucy. Number three, Lily. Love the name Lily.
All right.
Number two is Bella. So the number one female dog name is number two here, which means that the number one female cat name is also one of the top female dog names. Luna.
Luna again.
Luna again.
Come on, man. Get some separation between these animals.
It's popular.
And then finally, we have the male cat names. Any guesses for the top male cat names? Yes, there is some crossover.
Lucifer.
But two of them are not there. Lucifer's not bad.
How about Chuck?
Chuck.
That's Chuck the cat.
Chuck. Doug. Doug.
Get in here, Chuck.
So the number five male cat name is the number one male dog name. It is Max.
All right.
It kind of goes in reverse order here for half a second. So you got Max, Charlie at number four, which is number two for male dogs. The number three does go across. So Milo still sits there. So there you go. Now we got Milo in there as the proper cat name. Number two of the male cat names, Leo.
Okay.
Just fits. It's the astrological sign.
Right.
You're good to go there.
And Leo the lion. You got a little version.
Mm-hmm.
It's a cat.
Boom. Exactly. And this is the number one male cat name. It was one of my favorite movies as a kid. Oliver.
Really?
Yeah.
Huh. I don't know.
It's a good movie.
Cat. Yeah. Well, it's a musical, right?
It is a musical. Shoot. You're thinking of it. Yeah. You're thinking Oliver and Company, right?
Well, I think it's just called Oliver.
With Billy Joel. Yeah. A good one. Trust me, Ted.
Just wait for the text, Mike.
Okay,
I don't know a ton of musicals. Oliver the Musical is one of the most famous ones about poor kids in an orphanage who have to steal.
Gotcha.
Is that what it's
about? Oliver Twist.
Yeah.
Yeah. Gotcha.
Oh, he's the Moore kid, right?
Please, sir, may I have some more?
Exactly.
Okay. Right.
Yeah, the Moore kid.
The Moore kid. Couple extra headlines here. A man in Pennsylvania won an election after he and his wife wrote his name in as a gag.
I saw that, but he ended up winning.
Right. All right, well, now he's got to buckle up.
Exactly.
He agreed to do it. He said, hey, man, you know, I take it serious. It's like, I did not think I would win, but I won, so I'm going to do my job.
Right. Jump in there, man. 1 out of 5 people have made a financial decision based on their horoscope.
Oh, Jesus.
All right.
Financial decision?
A financial
decision. That is a horrible idea.
Mm-hmm. I feel like we all in this room know one person who would have made a financial decision based on their horoscope. I'll let you know here during the break.
Does pound cake have anything to do with
it? It does.
Okay. That's very sweet and dense.
Mm. A new study found that using a supportive voice could help you get ahead at work.
That's a great idea, Mike.
Exactly. What do you know? If you're just, you know,
if you're supportive, people like having you around.
Exactly. And you're not being demanding or anything like that.
No kidding.
A truck driver in Pennsylvania went full Ricky Bobby, and I'll give you the entire story 1 hour from now.
Think about cock headlines are coming up 1 hour from now. In the meantime, let's get a contestant online for profile this at 206-421-ROCK. All right, have we made it to drinking time?
Realtors abide by a code of ethics. This is Article 9 in action. Beth, a first-time homebuyer, knew nothing about the home buying process, except that she wanted to buy a home. But her realtor had the expertise to make sure Beth understood every document, even giving her copies to review with her lawyer so Beth could close on her first home with confidence. Complicated things explained in simple terms. The difference between an agent and a realtor is real. Realtors are members of the National Association of Realtors. That's who we are.
This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. As we continue to listen, learn, and grow, we are amplifying Black voices and perspectives in an effort to start a new COVID-19 vaccine conversation. We're sharing stories intended to help us navigate this unprecedented time together and to co-create solutions in support of the Black community. Hear these stories at WeConsiderWA.org.
$20 million, $19 million, $6 million. These are all awards recovered for clients of Phillips Law Firm. To win big, you have to fight big. And Phillips Law has been fighting the too-big-to-fail insurance industry for decades. Not every case will have a multi-million dollar outcome, but Phillips Law will fight just as hard to recover the outcome you deserve. If you or a loved one has been injured in a car accident or on the job, call or click today at 1-800-JUSTICE or visit justiceforyou.com.